Hello, I'm Amy Torbert, the Assistant Curator of American Art at the St. Louis Art Museum. Some films in our Art Plus Movie series offer an escape from our current moment, a year when so many lost so much, and when racial justice protests sparked a national reckoning to tell more complete, complex, and accurate histories from all perspectives, not just that of a dominant group. The 2006 film, The Pursuit of Happyness, starring Will Smith, and a 1939 painting by Walter Ellison at the St. Louis Art Museum, address some of these topics head-on. Both painting and film celebrate the hard work, ingenuity, grit, and resilience it takes to achieve success, and the joy that accompanies its attainment. Their stories are, however, simultaneously shaped by systemic inequities, which make success harder to achieve for some groups than others, and have been an inescapable part of many Black Americans' experiences. I hope that this art plus movies pairing offers a chance for contemplation and reflection on the struggles it takes to survive and to thrive, and on the essential support provided by loved ones. The Pursuit of Happyness tells the story of Chris Gardner, a single parent in his 30s, striving to build a better future for his 5-year-old son. The film was inspired by a memoir that Gardner wrote with St. Louis and Quincy Troupe. Though it takes place in 1980s San Francisco, the story feels all too relevant for our current moment. We follow Gardner as he undertakes an unpaid internship program to become a stockbroker. Without a salary, he endures homelessness for months as he works towards, and eventually achieves, a wildly successful career on Wall Street. In 1939, Chicago artist Walter Ellison painted a portrait of his parents, which he called Father and Mother Tintype. The last word in the title offers a clue about its creation. A tintype is an early kind of photograph. Ellison based his parents' portraits on a photograph of them that was taken in the 1920s. They wear their Sunday best, a smart and fashionable dress for his mother, Rosa, and a sharp 3-piece suit and tie for his father, Sidney. Both the Ellisons and Chris Gardner recognized the important role that clothing plays in the pursuit of success. One always needed to dress to impress. To this realistic portrayal of his parents, Ellison then added surreal or imaginary elements that convey more personal meanings. The long stalks and seeds in the foreground are probably types of millet or sorghum, grains that could have grown on the farms where the artist and his parents had worked in Georgia. 60 years before Chris Gardner ran all over San Francisco in the pursuit of a job, the Ellisons also uprooted their lives for similar reasons. In 1924, the artist, his parents, and 5 siblings moved from Georgia to Chicago. In doing so, they participated in the Great Migration, when 6 million African Americans moved out of the South to find better jobs and escape oppressive Jim Crow laws. The Ellison family was fortunate, however, not to have faced the same housing precarity that forced Chris Gardner to be evicted from a comfortable 2-bedroom apartment and to move first into a motel and then homeless shelters. At the top of the painting, the building's internal layers and the neighborhood beyond are seen through a hole in the wall, edged with shattered glass. This disorder seems at odds with the Ellisons' clothing and characters, and most likely their actual living situation. During the Great Depression, Rosa Ellison purchased a 3-flat building on the south side of Chicago, which provided security for both herself and her descendants. But the artist chose to paint a somewhat dilapidated setting here, alluding to the often inferior living conditions that many African Americans endured. Even in northern cities like Chicago, discriminatory practices in renting and selling homes severely limited their options for housing in the 1930s and beyond. A large curtain, like one might find in a photography studio, hangs across the back of the painting. Though it is torn partially in the center, large trees decorate its edges, suggesting ideas of family, solidity, stability, and permanence. In the film, these ideas are connected with Chris Gardner himself, who acts as a strong, steady presence for his son. For Ellison, they are connected to his mother, whose straight posture echoes a nearby tree. She served as her family's matriarch and leader for 5 decades. This painting is also a memorial of sorts. The artist's father, Sidney, had passed away soon after the family arrived in Chicago, and 13 years before his son painted this portrait. It may seem slightly surprising that this painting, filled with personal meanings, would have left Ellison's family. But most of his dozen known works are biographical in nature, showing scenes that he experienced during the Great Migration and in his Chicago neighborhood. This painting came to the St. Louis Art Museum as an allocation from the Federal Art Project, a New Deal program that offered aid during the Great Depression to artists like Ellison. In exchange for a weekly stipend, he was required to submit paintings, such as this one, which would then be displayed in civic buildings and cultural institutions. So, to wrap up, how did Chris Gardner and Walter Ellison pursue their own happiness? The film answers the question for Gardner. He built a stable life for himself and his son and sought excellence throughout all his endeavors. For Ellison, I believe that the answer lies, at least in part, in his artistic practice. The support from the Federal Art Project in the 1930s and 40s enabled him to work full-time as an artist. After he returned from serving in the military during World War II, he stopped painting professionally and instead managed apartment buildings. But he continued to paint for his own enjoyment throughout his life. One of his nieces remembered how he always had an easel at the ready in his living room. As she recalled, his apartment always smelled of paint and glue. He was always working on something. We hope that you too are able to work on something and towards something that brings you happiness. Thank you for watching this Art Plus Movies program. We invite you to share this link to connect family and friends with Art Plus Movies. You can also connect with us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.